We designed the Braille thingy to help make learning the Braille code fun and exciting for students who are low vision or completely blind. Here are the parts to this design. The sheet. This thin 3D printed sheet has 6 cutout boxes on top of 6 cells, all containing 6 circular holes. This sheet works along with an all-in-one board and can be easily secured by 2 large clips that can be found at any office supply store. The next part is the holders. These are small 3D printed boxes that fit onto the sheet. They contain magnets on the back and small clips on the top and bottom in order to hold flashcards. We used PIF printed flashcards cut to the same dimensions as the boxes, which includes the printed letter along with the Braille dots. Small columns with rounded tops were 3D printed to make the Braille dot used for the sheet. They have small magnets underneath to help secure them to the board. There are 3 main ways to use this system. 1. I used the word game as the example here. Place the desired flashcard letters onto the boxes and place them in the empty box slots on the board. Next, have the student place the 3D Braille dots into the corresponding holes in the Braille cell directly underneath each letter box. When a low vision student is ready and no longer needs the Braille prompt, simply take away the boxes and write in whatever word you would like them to practice. And once again, they will fill the corresponding 3D printed Braille dots in. 3. Have the student use the empty Braille cells as a guide to fill in the appropriate dots to whatever word is in the boxes. And voila! They have created and learned Braille in a new, exciting and fun way.
Oval masker. 3D printed base the size of standard letter-sized paper. There are slits running down both of the long sides that work as a track. A piece of paper can be slid onto the base and a mask fits onto. 2. Small pieces that fit into the tracks and allows the masking to move as you read. Quadrant math grapher. This is a 3D printed base about 9 inches by 9 inches with a thin base border all along the sides. There is a thin piece of cork board that is cut to size and glued onto the base to allow the placement of pins. Next, there is a thinner square that fits on top with the help of 4 circle cutouts that correspond with 4 small columns on the base. This top piece contains a 4 quadrant graph with an X and Y axis. We even developed a corresponding graph paper that can be placed in between the top and bottom plates so that the plot points made by the push pins can be visually seen on the print copy of the graph paper. Single quadrant grapher. This is built off the same design as the quadrant math grapher. The only difference is that instead of 4 quadrants, there is only 1, allows more room to plot on a specific quadrant. Depending on the placement in relation to the user, any of the 4 quadrants can be represented at one time. Hole coloring guide. We 3D printed out a simple sheet with different sized holes that can be clipped onto one of those amazing all-in-one boards by APH. This was to help these specific students who had mobility and muscle control issues be able to track and produce a piece of artwork as independently as possible. We also made backing coloring sheets using the guide. This fish's name was Hootie. Finger pencil holder. We are working with a visually impaired student who depends almost solely on one finger to write and draw with. We found a print that someone was using as a customizable finger splint and made a custom pencil slash crayon holder that he could use in conjunction with these activities and IEP goals. Map of our office. This is a 3D printed map of our office. Here's the kitchen and that's where I work. Note taker model. A blind student was going to present his Braille Sense U2 note taker to his class and asked me if there was any way to make a small model of it using the 3D printer. I at first told him I couldn't, but then realized how proud that idea made him and took my best shot. He loved it and requested about 610 to pass around. He was so happy to have a model of something that was a representation of a real tool in his life. Mini portable light box. Remixed this awesome print using Brain Enigma's box design. Added lid support and customized tops for sorting activities. We have used them with some of our CVI kids and they love the customizable high contrast sorting games that ensue. We added a remote controlled light that can change color and intensity with the press of a button at Amazon for around $5. It's also good for when the classroom is lit. Rotor box. This is a simple model that can be used as a tactile demonstration when teaching a rotor gesture for voiceover. Once you print two pieces, simply slide on the small circle to the middle of the big square and it spins very nicely, perfectly mimicking the rotor finger movement on an iOS device. Also helps students to realize the circle matches up to choices. Isn't voiceover great? I think so.